Hello friends and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video we are going to start a very new topic, that is the eukaryotic cells. In the last few videos humne baat ki thi about prokaryotic cell and different kind of things which are present inside it. So humne baat ki about the general characters of a prokaryotic cell. After that we have talked about the cell envelope in detail, as well as we have talked about the gram staining procedure and the ribosomes and inclusion bodies. So हमने वहां पर राइबोसोम, यूकैरियोटिक राइबोसोम की भी बात करनी थी. यहां पर हम स्टार्ट करेंगे यूकैरियोटिक सेल की जनरल स्टडी. ओके, व्हाट आर द जनरल फीचर्स ऑफ ए यूकैरियोटिक सेल, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक वन ऑर्गेनली इन ईच लेक्चर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इट इन डिटेल. ओके, सो व्हाट आर यूकैरियोटिक सेल? यू मींस ट्रू एंड कैरियन मींस न्यूक्लियस. इट मींस द न्यूक्लियस इज वेल डेवलप्ड in the eukaryotic organisms and it is surrounded by a nuclear envelope. Okay, nuclear envelope. जो the nuclear envelope था वो absent था in case of prokaryotic organism. Pro means primitive and karyon means nucleus again. So they are not having a well developed nucleus, as well as the nuclear envelope is absent in them and all the important membrane bound organelles are also absent. लेकिन यहां पर इन यूकैरियोटिक सेल द न्यूक्लियर एनवेलप इज प्रेजेंट, द न्यूक्लियस इज वेल डेवलप्ड एंड द कंपार्टमेंटलाइजेशन ऑफ साइटोप्लाज्म इज ऑलरेडी देयर. कंपार्टमेंटलाइजेशन मींस देयर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ कंपार्टमेंट्स. ओके, एंड दोस कंपार्टमेंट्स विल बी परफॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फंक्शन. सो कंपार्टमेंटलाइजेशन सिंपली मींस दैट द मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनेल्स आर गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इन यूकैरियोटिक सेल. So what are eukaryotes? The four kingdom out of the five kingdom classification given by R.H. Whittaker are eukaryotic in nature, except the bacteria. So what are the five kingdoms? Monera, which is including Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. So since they are bacteria, they are prokaryotic. After Monera, there is Protista, then Fungi, then Plantae, then Animalia. So Protista are unicellular but eukaryotes. Then fungi are multicellular eukaryotes. They can be unicellular as well. For example, yeast or the Saccharomyces, that is unicellular fungi. Okay. After that, plants, they can they are also eukaryotic and they are photosynthetic as well. Okay. They are photosynthetic. They can synthesize their own food. After that, animals, they are not photosynthetic. They are heterotrophic because they cannot synthesize their own food. But all of them are multicellular and eukaryotic organisms. So the four kingdoms out of the five kingdom classification are eukaryotic in nature, and the single kingdom, that is Monera, is prokaryotic in nature. Okay, so char kingdom hai, ye hai hamari eukaryotic, and the compartmentalization happens in the eukaryotic cell. After that, some locomotory and cytoskeletal elements are also present. Cytoskeletal elements ka matlab hai, cyto means cytoplasm and skeletal simply means that they are providing the strength or the rigidity to a cell, as well as they help in the movement. How? For example, this is a cell and this is an organelle. So this organelle need to move from this side to this side, but it does not have any kind of locomotory appendage. Ye are cytoplasm ke andar organelle hai, iske koi haath pair nahi hai. So how does it used to move? There is some rigid things in the cytoplasm over there which will let this organelle move from this place to the this place. So they provide strength as well as they provide the motion also. Different kind of examples of cytoskeleton elements are MT, that is microtubules. Okay, there can be microfilaments, or we can call them actin filaments, and there can be intermediate filaments. Okay, so microtubule, microfilament, intermediate filament, these are different kind of cytoskeletal elements which are present in eukaryotic cell, jo ki ise rigidity or strength provide karte hain, as well as motion mein bhi madad karte hain. For example, aapne actin filament ka naam to suna hi hoga. Actin and myosin are the muscle proteins which helps in the contraction and relaxation of muscle. So this actin filament is present nearly in all the cells. Okay, but we used to talk about it specifically in muscles, क्योंकि वहां पर इसका रोल बहुत ज्यादा है और बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट रोल है इन लोकोमोशन, बिकॉज द मसल कॉन्ट्रेक्शन प्रोवाइड अस द स्ट्रेंथ टू मूव. ओके, सो माइक्रोट्यूब्यूल, माइक्रोफिलामेंट एंड इंटरमीडिएट फिलामेंट्स आर द साइटोस्केलेटल एलिमेंट्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द सेल. After that, the eukaryotic cell can be majorly divided into two classes. Okay, there are different kind of cells as well. For example, the cells of a protista, the cell of a fungi. But let's talk about the most complex cells, the cell of a plant and the cell of an animal. How do they differ from each other? What are the differences? What are the similarities? Most of the things are exactly similar in case of plant and animal cell. Most of the organelles, most of the functions. Okay, and many of the things are exactly similar except a few. So let's make a combined cell. Okay, this is going to be the same thing. Now let me tell you a trick. A trick is C. C for cell. Don't have to do anything else. What are the differences between plant cell and animal cell? In plant cell, there is a cell wall. We have already talked about it, that this is the cell membrane or plasma membrane, which is the delimiting structure in case of animal cell. But in case of plant cell, an outer wall is also present, which is called as cell wall, which is absent in case of animal cell. So the cell wall, C for cell wall, is present in plant cell but not in animal cell. Then C for central vacuole. Okay, we are going according to the trick. C for central vacuole. Central vacuole means there is a large vacuole in case of plant cell, which is obviously going to be central because it occupies most of the space of a plant cell. अब कोई चीज अगर सबसे ज्यादा space occupy कर रही है तो वो कहीं ना कहीं central position पर आ ही जाएगी and it will shift the other organelles to the corner. Okay? So a large central vacuole, okay, is also present in the plant cell, which is, you know, that much bigger vacuole is not present in the animal cell. So central vacuole is also a kind of important character in plant cell. Then chloroplast. We know very well, as we have discussed, that plant used to perform photosynthesis. And how do they perform photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is performed by a pigment that is chlorophyll, which absorb light. That chlorophyll pigment is present in chloroplast. Okay, and that chloroplast is present in the plant cell. So let's remove this vacuole. There is, okay, structure like this. This is the thylakoid membrane. So this is chloroplast. So this chloroplast is present in plant cells only. No animal cell has the chloroplast. So this is also starting from C. So three C's are cell wall, chloroplast and central vacuole, which are present in plant but are absent in animal cell. Now animal cell may be kuch hai jo plant cell mein nahi hai, and that is also starting from C. So centriole. You can also call chloroplast as plastid, which is given in NCERT. But you cannot remember it like that, okay? So I have written it chloroplast, which is also the same thing, so that you can memorize it with the help of a trick. All of them are starting from C. So during cell division, the centriole has a very important role. The centriole are present like this in a perpendicular way. Okay, this is the one portion of centriole, this is the another one. They are making an angle of 90 degree with each other, okay? 90 degree. So they are perpendicular. Similarly, the other centriole will be present at the different pole. So there are two poles of a cell, okay, two different corners, and at both of these corners or poles, the centrioles are present and they will be surrounded by some material, and this whole complex is now called as centrosome. We will talk about that in detail. So this is the centriole, which is present like that. Jab yaar cell division hoga, we have already talked about the cell division, hum pura chapter kar chuke hain. Okay, the cell division over, this is the metaphase which I am making over here. So there is a metaphasic plate. There are spindle fibers which are attached to the kinetochore. Okay, here a proteinaceous disc is present called as kinetochore. Okay, this kinetochore attaches to the spindle fiber, and the spindle fiber itself attached to this centriole. Okay, so yahan se arise hote hain wo. So that's why centriole is very important for the cell division process, and they are present in animal cells only. No plant have the centriole. So in case of plant, we used to call the cell division as anestral. Okay, because this is called the ester formation. So ester formation kehte hain isko, and since this ester is absent in case of plant, so it is anestral. It means that it is absent. Okay, A for absent. So anastal simply means that there is no centriole in the plant cell, but there are centriole in the animal cell. So what are the major differences? Let's talk about the C. Okay, cell wall is present in plant cells only. Then central vacuole is present in plant cell. After that, chloroplast is present in plant cell, and centriole is present in animal cell. So these are the differences between plant cell and animal cell. कि क्या क्या इनमें differences होते हैं. और इसके बाद हम बात करेंगे about each and every organelle. We are going to talk about the nucleus. Okay? Because nucleus is very important. Nucleus is a double membrane bound organelle which carries chromosome inside it. And chromosome in fact contains the DNA or the genetic material. So to understand the physiology of chromosome and DNA, it is very important to understand nucleus in detail. Okay, so we are going to talk about the nucleus, we are going to talk about the chromosome, we are going to talk about chloroplast, mitochondria, peroxisome, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, and all different things including lysosome and microbodies. Okay, so abhi ye chapter actual mein start hua hai. Kyunki prokaryotes mein there are only 2-3 things such as ribosomes, inclusion bodies, and the envelope. But in case of eukaryotes, there is complex compartmentalization. So you have to go through each and every organelle very very specifically. Har organelle ke kuch functions hain jo ki bahut zyada peculiar hai, bahut hi zyada specific hai, aur unki jo structure hai wo bhi bahut hi zyada different hai kisi dusri organelle se. So it is quite important to go through them very carefully. We are going to start the detailed structure of different organelles from next video. I have already made a video on plasma membrane. So you just have to search plasma membrane by Vipin Sharma and you will get the video over there. I have already made 2 videos on that. I'll add that video on playlist also. So aap dekh sakte hain. Hum start karenge yaar cell wall se aur uske baad ek ek organelle se. So thank you so much guys for watching this video. If you really like this video, then hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much and stay tuned.